Assalamu alaikum, my name is Taimur Sikandar and today we are going to create another Android tutorial series. In this series we are going to create 2 to 3 videos, and the first video will be a splash screen, the second one will be login and sign up screen with shared animations, and the third one will be login or sign up using Firebase database, and we will try to authenticate and we will also move to complete that application as well. This is because I am getting a lot of requests to create 2 to 3 videos, so instead of creating separate videos, I am going to create a series. Okay, in this tutorial, we are going to create a splash screen. The one is on the screens. You can see the animation. And after 5 seconds, it will move toward our dashboard screen, which is not designed yet. So let me run it again. You can see we have some images, icons, and some text. And after the 5 seconds, it will be changing its screen to the next one. So this is what we will be creating. Stick together, watch the video till end, and do not forget to subscribe. Open new Android Studio project and go to the .xml section. Remove this hello world, and inside the constraint layout we will add a background color, and the background color I am using is this yellow one. Okay, in here we need to add image view, but before adding the image view we need to add images. And we will not use a regular way to add the image. Click on this drawable new and go to the batch drawable import. This is a plugin, so you can add plugin inside file settings and search for the plugin called batch drawable import. And if you don't know, you can watch the video, link is in the description. Click on this plus icon to add the image. And this image I am going to use. Click on the image and click OK to add. Okay, again you can play with these settings, and these are basically the multiple sizes. You can select and unselect for the target resolution, change its name, etc. Click OK and OK again to add the image. Once the image is added, you can check it in the drawable, and we have the image with the name of the image. We have 6 multiple screen sizes image. Now we have to use this image inside our project. Simply write the image wrap content, and the source will be this logo image, and we will design it inside our design section. So click on the design and click on the image. We need to add constraints as we are using a constraint layout. So to add a constraint, click on this plus icon. Plus icon, we will add 10 margin to both the sides. We do not want to make it at the top, so we will make the handle from the top. Change it to match constraint. Okay, our image is ready. We want to add some text here. And the text will be, because we are going to create a rent application, so we will name it Bull's Rent. Place it below this image and add the constraints. Make sure to turn them 0 because we want a responsive design, that's why. The width will be match constraint. Change its size. Seven TSP. And also we need to add its font family. And I am using the Bangers one. You can use as per your requirements and make it center. Search for text alignment and make it center. We also need to add a top constraint. Click on this plus icon as well. Add another text. And this will be a tagline. Change its size to 18 SP. Font family. Search for the more fonts, and I will be using antique fonts. Click OK to add them. Okay, the last thing is the alignment. Text alignment and make it center. Also add these constraints, make them 0 as well. and add a top constraint. Okay, our design is ready. Let's run the application and let's see how it looks like. Our application is running, but you can see there is a problem. We have our action bar and status bar is appearing, but we don't want to show them. So let's quickly hide them. To do that, go to the values and open the styles.xml, change the dark action bar to no action bar. Action bar will be gone, and to hide our status bar, we will go back towards the main activity. Let me show you the action bar. Click on this I and show live decorations. So this is the action bar where it is written bulls rent, and the top one is a status bar. So let's hide them the status bar as well. So to hide a status bar, we will write a single line, get window dot set flags, and inside we will search for the window manager dot layout params dot flag full screen comma, copy this one and paste. That's it, we are good to go. Let's run the application and let's see. Okay, now you can see our status bar and the action bar is gone, and our design is looking pretty responsive and it is looking too good if you ask me. So that's it for the design purpose. Let's go to the coding side and add the animations. To add animations, we first need to add a folder in the resource. Right click new and add our directory, name it anim for the animations. Click OK to add, and inside this folder right click and add new animation resource file. Name this resource file, use small letters with underscores, click OK. And we also want to add one bottom animation. Okay, so first of all we will design the top animation, and in here write translate that the effect we are going to use. So we are not moving from X delta, so we are simply putting 0%. We are moving from Y delta, and we will move -100% Y delta, and we need to add Android colon duration. Duration will be 1500. Okay, this is a translate. It will move our icons or the text from one place to another, and we are going to use another one, which is the alpha. This is going to add a fade effect in our project. So we'll add from alpha, from 0.1% opacity to 2 alpha 1.0%. So do not add percent sign in here in from and 2 alpha. Again, we need to add duration, copy and paste, close this one. Our top animation is ready. Copy the top animation, and inside the bottom animation we need to change one single line. We are not moving in x-axis, so do not change this. We are moving the y-axis. Instead of coming from the top, we are coming from the bottom to its original position. So the duration, we also want to fade this. That's it, top and bottom animations. Now we want to add these animations in our project. To add these animations, first of all, we need to add some variables. Animation top and bottom anim. Once these animations are added, we need to hook these animations, the one we created, and call these animations inside our project. So top animation is equal to animation utils dot load animation, and we will pass our animation here, r dot anim folder, and inside the first one is top animation. Press Ctrl D to duplicate the line and change this top animation to bottom animation. Don't worry about the error. We need to pass this, and boom, it's gone. This here. This means the context in which context we are going to use this animation and which animation. Okay, so bottom animation, change this as well. So we set our animations. So the next thing we want to do is to put or to set this animation on our image and on our text. So to do that, we first need to call this, call image view and name it image, and we have two text views. The first one is the logo and slogan. Okay, again add the hooks. The first one is image, so image view. Control D to duplicate the line and change this image view to text view, the first one, and text view second one. The first one is logo and the second one is slogan. Okay, now we have our animations and our image and text as well. So the next thing is to assign these animations to our image and text. The first one is image dot set animation. For this we are going to use the top animation and control D two times, change the top animation to bottom animation for both of the texts, and image to slogan, and the first one is logo. Okay, now we have assigned our animations. Let's run the application and let's see what will happen. Okay, our screen is animating and that is a good news, but it is a bit more speedy, so all we can do is to play a little bit with our animation. Go to the top animation and add the time to 2000 seconds and change to 50 so it can come less from the top. Again run the application. Okay, now you can see our screen is animating. Let me run it again and you can see it is animating slowly. So that's it what we want. Our animation is added and our splash screen is ready. Now the last thing we want to do is to move to the next screen. Once the splash screen appears after the 5 seconds or the 7 seconds maybe, depending on the requirement. So for that, go to the main activity.java and in here we first need to create a variable which will be private static int type variable. I am using the capital letters because it is a static one. So 1000 means 1 second and I am using the 5000 which means 5 seconds. Okay, to create a splash screen we will simply call the intent to call our new activity, but we will call this intent inside of a delay method, which is simply a one method which you have to learn. We will simply write in a second new handler. This will basically handle our delay process dot post delayed, and inside you have to write new runnable and click on the runnable with java.lang, and inside this run method you just have to call the next activity. This activity, main activity dot this, to the new activity which we will be creating in a minute. Okay, D should be capital, class name. Okay, and the next thing we want to start that activity and pass the intent. And do not forget to finish this activity, because if you do not finish when the user presses the back button, when he reaches to the dashboard and he tried to close the application, instead of closing, it will return back towards our splash screen. So finish will simply remove this activity from the activity list. Okay, in here we need to put a semicolon and comma, and then splash screen, the variable we have created with the time settings. with the time basically. So we need to create this dashboard. Go to the Java folder and right click new. Create a new activity with dashboard name. That's it. In the design, let's quickly give it a name. Grab the text view. Change the text to dashboard screen. And its size to 24 SP. Make it in the center, add constraints. Close this one, close this one. And yes, we are good to go. We added a handler and we call our next activity after the seconds. So let's run the application. So now after 5 seconds, our screen should automatically change to the dashboard. Our animation is working. And yes, our dashboard screen is appear now. That means our splash screen is complete and we have created our first part. So in the next video, as mentioned before, I will create a login screen and sign up screen with shared animations. So do not forget to like this video if you learn something new. If you're new to the channel, subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon for more videos. Thank you for watching. Take care. Allah Hafiz.